Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Chatham Club, Chatham community. We're here shooting live from the Chatham, not quite, makeshift, in-home Chatham Club gym. I'm here with one of my longest standing clients as she stands there waiting the jump rope. This is Lori Cameron. I'm Frank Azzarello, personal trainer at the Chatham Club. Guys, I gotta tell you, lots going on in the world right now, but guys, we can't stop, well, hope for anything. But guys, we got a makeshift gym right here. We gotta stay positive throughout everything. We're trying to shoot as much possible fitness videos as we can. This is gonna give you another option. As you can see, I'm using a room right now in my current place. Actually, another bedroom. So, got what I had to get. Again, guys, if you have equipment at home, and I don't mean to take Lori's spotlight, because it's all about Lori right now. I have a power block that goes from 5 to 50 pounds. I have two kettlebells, 45 pounds each. I have a TRX right there, a perfect pull-up bar. There's a makeshift band for any trunk rotations behind Lori that is attached to the doorway. I have some mats, I have a Bosu, some med balls. Of course, I got my Chatham Club banner right there, which is the class crew shirt that Lori's wearing right now. If you turn around, we got our little slogan from way back when. 4C, staying fit, and as fresh as bread every day of the week. And guys, that's what we're focusing on, guys. Just move just a little bit. I know you guys are all crammed up. Maybe some of you are, you know, working from home, hopefully, or maybe still working. If not, guys, I know what you get. You know, everything that's going on right now, the world is in turmoil. But as I've kind of preached, and you know, everyone at the club, my fellow colleagues and trainers, management, guys, stay positive, pick up one another, and keep moving. It's easy to feel sorry for yourself at home, all right? But try and inspire, try to stay motivated, pick each other up. With that being said, we're gonna get started. Lori's gonna be doing an upper body workout today. Like I said, Lori and I have been training for, what has it been, 5 years?
Yep.
Right? She is my superstar. All right, let me tell you, all right, 5 years ago, Lori had a discussion. Andy doesn't like social media, but you can call him something else. He won't be upset. Lori couldn't even ride her bike a mile. I think she made it, how long was it, like a half mile?
Might have been a mile, but as soon as I hit the hill.
A mile, all right. As soon as she hit the hill, what did she do? I mean, what do you do on a bike? You ride it, right? She got off the bike, she started pushing it, but on top of it, she had to make a collect call. Luckily, there were cell phones in that time. It's been, what? That was probably 5-6 years ago. But she had Andy come and pick her up. Yeah, now I'm gonna get whipped for that. And that's when she knew that it was time for her to get her butt off the couch and get to work. And the rest is history. Since then, Lori has done a Spartan race, all right, which we're probably gonna do in July. We're trying to gather that at the club. You guys are welcome to join that. Again, that's everything. Once we get back to social gathering, that's what we're gonna do. We just got our Asbury half run of Palooza closed off, but she's also run three half marathons. All right, she's done anything else aside from being able to deadlift over 200 pounds? She did two Spartans. She did the city field Spartan in the lovely Flushing Meadows. Gotta say, that's close to home or where I'm from originally. But I mean, my point with Lori is she's accomplished a lot. Physically, it's also helped her mentally. And she also inspires a lot of people on a daily basis. So that's why we're here right now. And she's always looking to progress and looking to step over the next mountain. So guys, if you're watching at home, if you have some weights, guys, it doesn't matter. If you have a can of soup, you know, I'm not gonna do much. There will be body weight stuff. But if you have some weights, any weights, guys, you can pick up the volume. Any bands you may have, you can kind of work along with us, but we're going to be working with an ab wheel today, maybe a Bosu, which you don't need. We're going to use the band back here, TRX. I have my makeshift bench here, which was from a foot locker from when I deployed to the Middle East in 2006. Alright, it is stable. Look, about 175 pounds, I'm not going through right now. Guys, use a chair, use a desk. Yes, maybe I can make it up there. Have to jump. You know, anything you have, guys, you can make anything you want. All right, but just follow along. If this meets your criteria for what you have in the house, by all means, please join in. Jolly Lean, if you will. I call it, she has a lot of nicknames. Jolly Lean, she doesn't really like it. It's really the lean machine. Don't let that smile fool you, because she will take you out. You ready to roll? Let's get warmed up. We're gonna start with a warm up here right now. Don't trip over yourself. Lean, let's go. Guys, also, be careful. All right, social gatherings, this is one-on-one. I've known Lori for a while. We're taking precautions. I wipe everything down. I have my gloves on. Lori has her gloves on. I don't know if you can see over there, but we got our wipes, got a clean bathroom, etc. So we're gonna get moving. All right, look at that hair flying all around. All right. Guys, this is my first video, and I gotta make sure that the head is recording. So we're good. We're about 6 minutes in. I told Lori she'd have to go 2 minutes straight. All right, if she doesn't trip over her hair. Oh, there it is. It's right. You know what? No problem, because guess what? She's gonna jump right in, maybe. That is a longer jump rope. That's all they had left in Dick's. They had 9-foot jump ropes. All right. I probably should have grabbed some from the club. All right, but we're doing what we're doing right here. Lori just got back from Long Island, a long way from the trip to Jamaica that she was going to with her family that obviously got halted by this. But she, you know, she made do with what she had. Her and her family went up to see her mother in Long Island. Mom, how you doing? I know you don't like these muscles on her, but she looks great. I won't even say her age, but I would brag about her age because age is but a number. You got about 15 seconds, Lori. How you feeling?
Good,
that's right. Always with a smile. Guys, Chatham, members, people around, Morris County, the world. Guys, get up off the couch right now. It's easy. Have fun with it. Grab family, grab friends. You got 3, 2, 1. Relax. Nice trip at the end, Jolly Lean. You're good. You're going to drop down, guys. We're gonna do a little warm-up. We're going to use our TRX, guys. If you're at home, guys, you could grab a band. I'll show you another option. And guys, be safe with these movements. Something, my perfect pull-up is pretty sturdy. I just don't want to pull the roll down. All right, so Lori's just gonna do this for a warm-up because we're gonna be activating the muscle fibers in your chest. We're gonna be working upper body today, so I want her to get full flexion here. Good stretch, elbows to the rear, good posture in the body, neck is aligned. All right, we're gonna do 20 reps right there, Lori. And I will show you, maybe I won't right now. But guys, you could use a band if you attach it to a door and shut it through. I'll show you, I can use it with the knob. As long as the knob does not fly off, but if you have a band at home, look, it's the warm up right here. Wide stance, press away. Lori, are you admiring yourself in the camera right now? It's all good because she looks fantastic. All right, guys, modify, watch your range of motion here if you want to step out. Guys, this is just a warm-up, all right? And then we're gonna get into it. Looking good, Lean. Lean machine. Oh, this works pretty well, guys. Again, think about what you could have, guys. Do not panic about it. I know you're getting all riled up being inside. Plenty of stuff you could grab to do work with, all right? Just think about it. There will be more videos from other trainers coming. Again, some body weight, others with weights, with kettlebells. Again, a lot of my colleagues, they have a lot of equipment at home. If not, they will make do with what they have. All you need is a body. I think Lori's done about 38 reps because she can, but we're good, relax. All right, we're gonna come down. All right, and I just want you to do a high plank alternating knee in. All right, and then you're gonna do it with Jack. So one, you don't have to rush it. I just want flexion. We don't have to go firing out all cylinders like you're coming out of the gate. All right, and now we're gonna do high plank lateral shacks. One at a time, alternating, so you can do that. Show off, I like it. Just step, one at a time, one at a time. Left, right, there you go.
I know, it's easy.
That's my Lori voice, by the way.
Yes, that was easy.
Watch your posture there, Lean. We gotta be able to have a table, or we're gonna have to have breakfast after that on that table, so let's go. I don't know if you guys could see her, but looks good. She's wearing my favorite color, Superman. By the way, Lori, you're done in 3, 2, 1. Relax, we're gonna get started. Special shout out right now. Joe McIverna and Tracy and Joseph, who's back from college. Spring break, not quite at the beach, back at home in New Providence with mom, dad, and sis. Joe Mac, Trace, Joseph, and Gina. I want everyone to know that Gina is the daughter of two club members that are very close that do our classes, Joe and Tracy. But Gina is an artist, 15 years old, very talented. For Christmas this year, she made this, she drew this out, and she made this into a shirt and called it Captain for America. So, I mean, that's beautiful work, Gina. I love you. I hope you guys are doing well at home, and we'll see you soon. Hopefully you get to do this workout. All right, I'll talk to you guys soon, but where did Lena go? Oh, she's right back here. All right, so what we're gonna get into here, guys, we're gonna work upper body. We're gonna work a little bit of chest, back, and tri, and we're gonna work primary muscle groups with assisted muscle groups or secondary muscle groups, and then we're gonna go into a third movement that integrates your core along with the two muscle groups you have used. So we're gonna start with our power blocks right here, all right? And we're gonna go into a dumbbell chest press. Guys, I put a wipe in here. So if you see this, again, if you're cautious, as everyone should be, guys, use wipes, use gloves, but they're in there just to be a little safer in regards to what's going on right now. So again, hopefully my bench doesn't break, but it's gonna work. If not, I may go through the floor. So here's the first movement, good stability. We're gonna go into a dumbbell chest press. Guys, keep your feet planted down. All right, body parallel, shoulders, head, both making contact with the bench, full extension up to the top, bring the dumbbells together. All right, lean machine, you ready to roll?
Yeah.
You ready to show them what you're working with? As if we already haven't started, let's go. All right, if I didn't break it, you better not break it. Let's go. So Lori is, you are working today, right?
Yes.
Somewhat, all right, call from home. She is working this afternoon. A lot of chaos going on, but we're not here for the chaos. We're here to work, we're here to smile. We're here to burn out some frustration maybe. All right, now I sometimes get carried away talking. So she usually, you know, we're gonna go for 15 repetitions here. All right, this may be a little lighter than usual because I wanna make her look extra good. No, seriously, this is 25 pounds. Lori is very strong. She is a combination of everything. We're gonna go, what do we got, three more? You're asking me if I'm counting? Yeah, don't worry, don't get shy. Her and I, we're not the best counters, so I'll be good. One more. All right, relax. All right, bring it out. Guys, at home, make sure you're breathing when you're doing that movement. So an inhalation or breath in on the way down into the descent, and then exhale out as you press up and extend at the elbow. So, Giles, you're going to go into TRX tricep extensions here. All right, we're going to go 15 strong. I just lost my music, but that is all good. Only thing not good about gloves, as I contaminate it with my phone, is, well, you can't touch anything on your phone. It's very difficult. So we're gonna get grooving. Giles, make sure your alignment is good. Right, and she knows what she's doing. All right, she's been doing it for a while. I can almost call her a pro. All right, just to keep me in check sometimes. Nice alignment, there it is. She's abusive too. She likes to beat up her trainer. All right, so flex all the way down. Get a little deeper there, Bellaline, and extend, all right? Notice her posture, notice her alignment. All right, don't forget to breathe, Lee Machine. Keep it up. Sit, give me two more, Lee. And last one. Very nicely done, relax. Guys, we're gonna go into Lori's favorite. See, an ab wheel. These are classic movements. My great-grandfather.
These hurt 2 days later, yes. Right here.
I saw this back in 1988. My great-grandfather, the great Brown, Lorenzo Lanza, had this and would just roll with it. All right, the guy was incredible. Lori feels that this is the only thing she feels anymore, which means A, we probably need to go up and wait, or B, we're taking too many breaks or longer breaks. But
she feels this one all the time, and she lets me know the next day. So you go and you do it right now. Let's go.
Come on. This way. You can go through the window. Let's go. Come on. Nice. Look at the extension, Lori. That's on the flexion up. I don't want you to come. Keep the tension right there. I don't want you to come back to your heels unless you have to recover. So extend, reach, stop, and then go back down. You'll feel it more and more. You'll complain and yell more and more. Let's go. Oh, it's a little different on a carpet, but we are making do. That is how it's done, guys. Keep on rolling out the machine. Guys, if you're at home and you got this stuff, jump in. All right, it's a good way to work. If you have the space, use it. It's as simple as that. Don't fall off. She's almost falling off the cliff. That Bosu makes it a little more difficult. Guys, if you don't have a Bosu, just go from the floor. From your knees, find a mat, and then go there, all right? Talking too much, I'm losing count, but she's in a zone. Lori also does multiple classes at the club. There are a lot of different varieties of exercises you can do. Lori, go two more. But depending on how you're working, you go by time, 30 to 60 seconds, or in this case, reps, which should have been 15, but I'm sure may have been 23. With that being said, she's letting out some frustrations because she hasn't been at the gym. And she always tries to say, you need a sip of water. Where's your water? Did we throw that in the closet? Did we really throw the water?
No, it's right here.
All right, we got it. All right. She says she turns into a slug even though she gets, you know, on her worst days, she gets in 3 days of exercise.
I've been a slug for the past 2 months.
But... 2 months, maybe three or four. She just started coming back to class like 2 weeks ago and then all this happened. But you know what? She maintains. Guys, it's important to maintain. In times like this or if stuff happens in life, guys, find someone. Find something to do. Find something that motivates you. But Lori does a good job of maintaining no matter what. She doesn't realize how important that is. Just to move twice a week is better than move no times a week. All right, so her two or three times a week when she is busy with work or stuff happens, she makes sure she's getting in. So we're gonna try and keep this going throughout, and that's what you guys have to do. That being said, Ricky Shu, we're back up to set two of our dumbbell chest press. How was the weight the first time? Look, you got the wrong other side. Flip it around. There you go. These power blocks, all right, are a little, this is an old one. You know what? Up to 50 pounds. Use the increments over here, much like we have at the club. All right, sometimes the handles are a little confusing to figure out, but she got it. That's all. 15 strong here. Now remember you're breathing here, Lori. Flex in, extend up. Now normally, Lori, with the talking and everything, Lori's fit enough, she can take about 30 to 60 seconds. Your rest ratio is gonna depend on how long you want to, or how heavy your weight is. All right, obviously, if you're lifting heavier weights or you're looking to build, you're looking to put on size, you're gonna wanna take longer rest ratios, maybe 2 to 5 minutes. But we're looking for multiple benefits in regards to what Lori is working with today. So you notice we're stringing three movements in a row together. All right, she's probably working 2 to 3 minutes straight. So you're tapping in, you're almost tapping into your cardiovascular system as well. So we do a muscular endurance type exercise. And I got you. All right. You good? Okay. Go one more. Relax. And that's what she's doing. All right, another way to keep your heart rate up throughout is to continue to move it. All right, you're tapping here. Let's try some extensions. Guys, safety, safety, safety. I do this, I'm just making sure Lori doesn't pull the wall down. She's that strong. All right, let's go. Good job. All right, I'm gonna try and count this time, guys. Remember, find a zone, all right? This is a body weight exercise. Again, if she stays aligned, she's primarily working her triceps, and if she stays rigid, she may activate the midsection. For your core, and she's on her heels as well. Guys, you can stay flat-footed, or if you go on your heels, you can get more range of motion. But she's looking for 15 reps here, and then she's gonna jump right back into the Bosu rollout. All right, you're looking good. Good, good. Try and keep your wrist straight. Get your hair out of the way. Are you sweating already?
Yes.
Oh, she is shiny.
I hate triceps.
She is shiny. She always says,
I'm not there, never.
I'm not there.
Give me two more. Come on. And then you get to do your rollout. And relax nicely, done, lean machine. All right, right into the wheel. A little different on that carpet, makes it a little more difficult. Watch, you may fall off the Bosu. Yeah, the Bosu makes it unstable, as I said. Again, for people at home, you could do this from the floor. All right, you could do this from your knees, extend out, watch your range of motion. Keep the tension, glutes stop. I don't want you going all the way back. I'll tell you when, up, 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 stop. And then go back. You'll feel it. You'll keep contraction in your abdomen. gonna find that sweet spot in the carpet. May have found a divot. Are you fatiguing? Oh, yeah, that's a key rule of a trainer. You should not make your client laugh. Or my secret sometimes. As long as it's not heavy weights over there. All right, I'll be quiet now, Giles. Come on. Go two more. We're going to take a quick break, and then you can jump back in. And relax nicely. Done. All right, two down. We're going to go again into the third movement. Not the third movement, the third set. Lori, sip some water if you need to. How you feeling, all right?
Yes.
So what do you think's going on? Is Andy working today?
Yeah, he's working.
Andy, of course, is working. Andy will be in here one of these days, I know. But, guys, it's miserable outside right now. It doesn't mean you have to be miserable inside. So that is my point of all this, guys. Plenty of videos from the Chatham Club trainers that you can do without body weight. I know Chrissy Stanley's doing stuff, Jen O'Connor, Brett, Dennis. I mean, I think a bunch of people have done it. You guys have the video, do so. Again, this is something that's gonna be added. That being said, Lean, we're up. I think I'm talking too much. You think we can figure it out this time? It's all set for you. We're gonna switch it though, because I like the hands. I messed up now, see? I feel like we're
trying to trick me.
I know, I got tricked. Alright, this is not a diving board here, Lane. It looks like one, I know. How's the bench so far? Not bad, right? This is not a bench. This is a locker with, I don't even know what this is, but it works. I just put it together and it holds me, so we're good. Alright, we're back in. Guys, for you at home, if you're doing this by yourself, be smart about the weight. Be sure you have. Usually want to have a spotter, or you want to be safe about doing it. You better be sure you don't have any limitations in regards to lifting, because you don't want to hurt yourself at home alone. So find a partner if you have one, or a family member, and go to work. Lean, how you doing down there? Four more.
Okay.
Four, as in F-O-U-R. Sometimes I say four, and people say, I think I said one. I don't know. I don't hear it. Must be my Queen's accent. Lee, how are you? I don't sound, he does sound like that. Lee, you sound like that. Is that four?
Right.
Yeah, I thought it was four. We're done.
That was four.
Alright, run the TRX, Jaws. Right in. Right into it. Let's go. We're cooking now. And then it's time for a whole new round of... Oh, we're going to get some core. We're going to work some high plank rows from the bench. Don't go flying out the window here. Let's go. Good. Watch your posture. Now, guys, another thing to point out that I probably should have pointed out in circuit one, or round one, if you change your angle with your feet, if you step away from the TRX, if you step forward, it's gonna decrease your load acting down towards the flow, so it'll be a little, or to the floor. Yeah, exactly, see? Difficult. If she went back, she put her feet on the wall, I mean, that would be impressive. But she's showing you exactly the difference. Difficult. You see those triceps yelping, we should put them out right there. Let's go. Three more. Last two, Lee, looking good. That's it. Woo! And relax, nice, ring it out, give me a fist bump, a gloved fist bump. Now, Lori's gonna show you without the BOSU. All right, so if you guys, I just want you guys to be aware that if you're using a wheelie, you could do it from the floor, it'll make it a little less difficult. You know what else you could do? You could inch out. So I tell people that have lower back issues, inch out, guys. Just flex the hip, start in, extend, back, up. All right, that's another modified. All right, so let's roll, Lean. Come on. You'll notice she gets a little more range of motion. Notice her alignment with her neck. I don't want you sticking that chin on the carpet there, Lee. Keep it aligned. Keep the chin out of this. Let's go. That's it, Lori. All the way through. Looking strong as usual. Give me three.
This is easy.
Yeah, I know what she thinks. because I can tell by how she works. Although she almost went down with that one. I better stop talking. Relax. Nicely done. Lean, sip some water, guys. We're moving on.
Those will hurt tomorrow.
I'll record the conversation so you guys can hear it. Sip water if you have to, guys.
If you get out of bed the next day, you will hurt.
If you need to take a break, please do so. We're going to move into our second round of movements, which is going to be an emphasis on your back. We're going to work unilateral, your back and biceps, and we're additionally going to work on the core from a lower plank position. But we're going to get started here, and I can give Glory some solid weight here. John Palma, the John Palma anthem right here, Dance Monkey. Bench here, and we're going to do unilateral high plank rows. Normally, I like Lori doing renegade rows from the floor. All right, today we're going to show multiple movements, but a renegade row, guys, if you want a little more advanced movement, you could go right into this. Widen your stance, watch your posture in your back, and row. Row, that's a high plank movement. That's a renegade row. If you wanted to be a little more advanced, you could do a push-up with it. Row. Row, neck is aligned, body is rigid and straight, push. All right, we're not gonna do that because Lori just did chest press and she just coming back from a long break. And we'll probably do that next time when we have an emphasis or focus on primarily working the back. So here's another slightly advanced move. We're gonna do a high plank unilateral row. Again, same alignment here, we're just gonna use work one side at a time. So feet wide base, so you have more stability. Alright, watch this. Guys, be smart. Keep your hands centered. Alright, this is my bench, your bench may be different. Row. Row. Chest is parallel. Alright. Try and eliminate this sway because you're monkeying up. Trying to stay rigid. Row. We're going to go 12 to 15 each side. Lori, you're up. Center your hand up here. And the wipe down, and there is a bacteria cloth on there, so if you want to take the gloves off for this one, you absolutely can. You need the wipe down right there. Watch that sway. Separate your feet just a little bit and bend the knees. No stress, no pressure here. Keep your form. Sit, Lori. Good. Woo! Tricep looks good from this angle. If the camera was only here, I could prove to you that they are actually existing on your body. Look pretty good, not bad. I'm sure you're getting lasagna and meatballs and all the Italian food at your mother's. It looks like you must be working out or something. All right, she's switching side now, guys. Good form.
Pretty good there. Not bad.
You got really nice form. Don't forget to breathe. Guys following at home, hopefully you're doing well. Hopefully you're able to do some of this. Just keep on moving. Take a break when you need to. Watch your form. Any discomfort, pause, take a break. Jump back in when you're ready. Benefit about these videos, guys, is you can always press the pause button. Especially when Lori may slide off with that towel. Alright, we're gonna go right into a TRX. You got this, man. Alright, you're gonna go into a curl here, so we're gonna adjust our TRX. Make sure the adjustment's there. Slightly off, I'm gonna pull this up a little bit. How you feeling? Good. All right, now we're waving the plane. All right, so guys, keep your triceps away. Your body is rigid here. Hips extended, rotate it. All right, extend out. You'll see some people do a roll, a row, a close grip. I don't want that. keep your triceps away from your body, your elbows away from your body, and wave in the plane. Fly boy, fly girl, Anthony and Devin, shout out to them. We're waving in the plane. Hopefully the wall doesn't come down. Let's go, lean. Keep those elbows and triceps away from the aisle. Let's go. That's it. Looking good, lean. You're holding strong. Nice job. Keep it up. Too strong. Stop showing off. She's like,
yeah, I got business. I know.
Four more. Last three. Come on. Dig in. Don't break my fan. Oh, there's a kick. Oh, a little karate. Oh, relax. All right. Now we're moving in. What do we got? We got plank reach with scissors. So you're going to go into a low plank position. Back this up a little because I don't want people to see you. Hopefully we're still recording. All right. So low plank reach. And then you're going to do plank jack. Reach, reach, jack out. Good. Good. Guys, notice lack of sway here. We're not in a boat, although Lori wishes she was on a boat right now. All right, but when you reach out, try not to sway, all right? If you keep your feet closer together, you will minimize your stability and it'll make it more difficult. So guys, if you're new at this, start with your feet a little wider. Try to reduce your sway and try to isolate your abdomen as you really fully extend at the elbows. Good job, Joss. Keep it up. All right, you can pick it up a little if you want. Good job, baby. Nice job. How you feeling?
Okay.
We're going to go for time here because, again, my rep counting right here is not on point. We're going to go 5 seconds. Give me one more. 3, 2, 1. Relax. Nicely done, lean. One in the books. How you feeling right now? Anything to say to the camera? This is real. So if you come and zoom in, she's not camera shy. You'll notice that's not, I didn't pour water on her. She is working. She is here to work. Maybe a little frustrated, but she's glad she's here. Look at that smile. She knocked me out with those elbows.
That makes me smile.
Yeah, exactly. So we're gonna come back in. We're going into the high plank rows. I'm gonna give Lori, just say another 20 to 30 seconds. Lori's sip water. All right, we're gonna jump back in. Little la isla. What, the kettlebells? She didn't want to do leg day today. I want to do wall.
I
want
to do upper body today.
I was hoping we could do legs because I like to show off what she has with her legs.
Legs are fun with those.
They are. We have kettlebells. You can't see them right now, but kettlebells are fun. I mean, Lori can throw around 60-pound kettlebells. She can lift them. She can thrust them in space. She's unbelievable. That being said, what are you doing? Just sitting around. Time to go to work. Don't worry about the towel. It's going to slide off. This is clean, I promise you. I wiped it down. I vacuumed this room 3 times yesterday. I wiped it down. I felt like a combination of Jorge, myself, maybe management trying to get this going. But guys, we got it here.
And Jenny, she's the best.
Oh, why? How could I forget Jenny? Absolutely. MVP throughout this whole scenario. Keep it up. Go to the other side. Let me jump back in. You know they're gonna tell on the video, right?
Yes,
how bad my counting
is.
Well, that's on me. That's another top rule of training. Count, don't make your client laugh. Don't follow this video. We're just having fun. But she's working. I know what she can do.
Ow.
Come on. What does that ow mean? I didn't say ow in this video. 12. Take 12. Now, joking or no, the ow is important. All right, so guys, if you feel any discomfort during a movement and your form starts to go, stop doing the movement. It's as simple as that. Stop. All right? If you notice that your form is going, or you feel you're working something else other than the move, or other than the muscles that you're actually doing, stop the movement, rest, jump back in, or just call it a day, or call it, all right, that's the set I'm in. I normally set a zone in repetitions of 10 to 15, 12 to 15. We're doing more volume, more it will go by time, or you know, even more rest of this body. We're gonna go into the curls. Let me get in on here. Nope, yep, you almost did that. You're gonna do that. She likes to do the triceps a lot, so she's gonna turn around, but we caught her. All right, let's go.
Back here.
Triceps, what? Oh, yeah. Keep your elbows and triceps away from your body. Keep them up. Wave in the plane. You know, Anthony, Devin, Jim Connolly, Jimmy. You know a lot of pilots, huh? We all do. That's what the community's about. Let's roll. Eight. I'm getting hot in here. Holy moly. I have to turn on my CC fan right there. Guys, that shirt is held up by a fan. That's what I'm working with here. It works. Windows are open. Four more jobs. Come on. Guys, also, a little motivation, a little pep in your step, find good music, anything you love. One more. Relax. But you guys know that. Who doesn't know that music could set your mood, whether it's good or bad, or maybe you want to be sad, you want to listen to sad music. But I don't know, when you're lifting, you need some little uplifting stuff. Bruno always does it for me. My class knows that I love Bruno. George, if you're watching, gorgeous George loves Bruno. Glory, lean, plank reach jack. She's just floating around. She likes to chase butterflies. Let's go. Reach, reach. Let's go. Watch the sway, Giles. Keep it up. Good. Good, good. Four. Guys, you could be quick, or you could take your time and focus on lengthening your arms and then separating your feet or abduction farther away. Alright, but really focus on the form and swaying. Guys, this is an isometric move for your shoulders, your chest, even your biceps slightly, and triceps, but this is mainly hitting your bridge right here, your core. Alright, also, you're jacking out, so you're working the abductor and adductor muscles, and your back. This core movement pretty much hits the entire body, including your cardiovascular system. You're getting your heart rate up. Laura, are you breathing a little?
Yep.
So heart rate's up. Give me one more. And relax. Nicely done. Come up, you beast. That was a compliment, by the way. Sometimes you say beast, you're like, I don't want to be a beast. But that is a beast. All right? That is a lean machine. All right? She's been doing this for a long time now. Certifiable. And I mean that in a training perspective. Yeah. Guys, we have one more set here. All right, and we're gonna jump right back into our high plank rows. All right, if you need water, take it. Otherwise, you're gonna jump right back in about 15 seconds. Chill, all right? What'd you have for breakfast? A bagel.
A bagel.
I knew she had a bagel. You know what, I had a half bagel. All right, I cut it in half, I had it. Guys, you have to monitor what you're eating. Lori loves bagels and she loves Carvel ice cream.
That's why you gotta do this.
That's why she works. There are reasons to work. People have goals. One of Lori's goals is to work out so that she can have her bagels and then maybe go to Magic Fountain after, her favorite ice cream place.
They're open for the summer again.
They are open for the summer. All right, that is a plug right there. Not a healthy plug, but sometimes you need a cheat day. All right, but she's been cooped up. It's her first workout back. A bagel's not necessarily a bad thing. Just don't go slamming cream cheese. So 2 to 3 hours prior to a workout, maybe have, you know, not a super deli bagel that's gonna be 500-600 calories. That's gonna affect how your workout goes. But again, it's good for energy prior to your workout, just not too soon. All right, you switching over?
Yes.
You're good. You're good. But you know that. Let's go. Form is there, guys. Again, things to watch out for. Again, if Lori is starting, she's grunting, she's fatiguing, she could always come down, place the weight, shake it out, and jump back in. But watch the sway. If you start to give, put the weight down like she just did. We're going to go four more, wiping off her hands because she's got her wipe, her antibacterial wipe. Let's go. Be four strong here. The last one. Relax. Good job. All right. Here we go. It's getting sweaty in here. All right. Wave in the plane. You're good. Triceps and elbows away. Look at that. Lean. That's a nice angle she's got. Leaning back.
This makes it harder.
It does. Again, same thing as we were discussing with the triceps. If she stepped back, all right, it would be easier. If she stepped in, all right, it would make it a lot more difficult there. She would probably want to bring her triceps closer to her body to compensate. So. How you doing?
Okay.
All right, give me three more. Plank reach jacks. Let's go right into it now that we've got that. Did you just yawn or groan?
No, I sighed.
Oh, it was a sigh.
It was a sigh.
In my multiple choice, I wasn't even right. Reach jack. That's it. A happy jack right there. Not a flap jack. Come on. Good job. Looking good. Keep it up. Jack. Guys, stay in tune at home. If you're with us, keep on moving. Come on. Working for the weekend on the it is Thursday, right? Can you just take a break to tell me what day it was?
No, I used that as an excuse.
Ah, see? So she's smart like that. She looked at me like she was going to chime in. And then she just used it as an excuse. That was a good one. I'll give it to her. But she's right back into the movement. All right? Wayne, give me three more after this one. That's a penalty. Let's go. Also, I didn't recognize this with Lori here. Guys, if you're doing this, switch your hand each time. So if you go left, right, jacked. All right? When you come back down, go right, left, jacked. That is my fault. Bad cueing. All right? But that is the end of round two. And we have one last round right here, right now. We're going to work with chest flies, so we're going to go with the power block. Guys, sip water, towel off at home. We're going to enter the conclusion here. Lean is just showing off now with her shirt. All right. So we're going to go into flies from our bench. Guys, if you have a stability ball at home, this is a 75 centimeter stability ball. All right. Advisable, maybe big, but it will sink in. It's kind of like a waterless waterbed, as I'll describe it. Good definition, right? Guys, we're going to use this stability ball as long as Lori can get on. And, all right, that's a core move right there. All right, so with this movement, I want you to watch my elbows. They stay fixed right there. All right, so I don't want you fully extended. You're going to put a lot of strain on your elbow there. So keep a slight bend here and then adduct in. All right, bring the weights together. All right, keep your hips extended. Inhale the bottom. Exhale as you bring the weights together up. All right, inhale down. Exhale up. Lady, ready to roll. I'm trying to knock me off. It is. I told you it's like a waterless waterbed. No. That way. Let's go. Hips up. Press up. Yes, but see how you just flex at the elbow?
Yeah.
Keep a slight bend in the elbows. So, come in right there, and then
like that.
Make the movement about the shoulders. Abduct, bring them in.
Oh, bring them down?
Yes. No press. Although you just give me ideas.
Absolutely no credit.
You know what? Ladies and gentlemen at home, children of all ages, Lori just added an additional move, so she's going to do a close grip press down. This weight is light for her, at least on the press, but not so much on the fly. Guys, separate. Remember, keep a slight bend throughout the entirety, except for when you're pressing. And inhale down, exhale up, inhale down, triceps hit the ball. That's good. Again, watch the lock of the elbows. How's this weight for you?
Fine.
Fine as in, not too light. She would have said too light, too easy. So again, this is an additional, the neutral grip press.
And you're right, it's light on this.
Yes,
but
it's weight.
But it's good on this.
That's why, I don't want you locking. When you go back down, don't, when you abduct, slight bend. Yes, there you go. Give me three more, which means six more. Last one. Nice job, guys. You notice her hips are extended. All right, and she's, because you're on the stability ball, all right, you're activating, you're engaging your core. And when you extend at the hips or bridge out, you're engaging your glutes, all right? It's a little bit of everything. Primary mover here is pectorals. You'll feel in the biceps. And then because Laura's doing the neutral grip press, all right, she's gonna feel in the triceps as well. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna try this. We're gonna do a reverse fly, although, let's see something right here. Freeze a knob is great. We're gonna do a band high pull. All right. So focus on bringing your elbows back. All right. Triceps align with your shoulders. Your feet are hip width, good posture, and pull back. Exaggerate the squeeze. All right. Go. All right. Here, look. Try and exaggerate the squeeze. Like you're trying to squeeze an orange between your traps and scaps. And get those elbows up, up, up high. Good. Not about speed here. I want you to exaggerate contraction towards the top portion of your back. And try and focus on getting those elbows up. I want to elbow me in my big nose. Come on. Boom. Right there. Good. Doubling again. Guys, this is a band. A lot you can do with bands. This is a light band. I have a medium band. It's somewhere a heavy band. I don't know what I did with it, but it's somewhere. Put two more on me. And relax. Nice and done. Guys, all right, we're going to do one of my favorites. I like to do with the cables I have with a band here. Guys, make sure if you have a band with a handle, I attach it to the knob inside the door. Alright, and then I pulled it up and I shut the door. If you don't have this attached and for some reason the door comes flying off or open, you're gonna get whiplash. Something not good. So we're gonna work on an axe press. Alright, your resistance is dependent on how far out you are, but we're gonna come fully extend. Close your feet are, alright, the more difficult and unstable you become. EG, it's you. Eric showed me this movement a couple years ago. I love it, I've inherited it. Now all my clients get it. Matty Bomb, you know you miss it. So focus here, control. This is gonna feel easier, all right? But I want you to go slower. I want you to focus on keeping your elbows extended. And again, it's gonna be a little different because I weigh, oh, I don't know, about 40, 50 more pounds in there. Good. Raise. All right, she's trying to fight the resistance, which is trying to pull her back, but she's staying nice and aligned. She's following her forehead down through her belly button. Try and trace that line. All right, feeling this lane?
Yep.
All right, good. And like I said, if there's an issue with your stability, one, your stance, all right, it'll give you more base support or balance. You won't want to get pulled back. If you bring your feet closer, all right, you're going to feel a lot more unstable. Therefore, you're going to get a lot more work in that midsection area. Again, this is targeting her obliques, rectus abdominis, but as you notice, we're going up and down. Anterior delts are working, triceps are working. They look pretty good, y'all. All right, let's go one more. So I'm pretty sure she did about 23. You guys are counting at home, they're like, he is the worst counter. I mean, Dennis knows, he is his pitch count counter. All right, this is a true story. But all right, form didn't fail, so she's all right. We're back in on this side, guys. We're almost home, guys. Almost finished and just in time for lunch. So here we go. Lean machine. Lean machine. Let's go. Get it back here, Lean. Do what you do. Having a good time. Come on. What do you want? Relax. Nicely done, guys. Round one of set three in the books. How we feeling at home? Everyone all right? Hanging? Still with us? People probably tuned us off, you think? We're going to put on a show, don't we? You want to do a dance? No? You want to Jimmy? Do the Jimmy punch?
You should do a handstand.
No. A fall over? No, no.
I know.
You fall over. It goes right out the window. All right, we're going to take a little more time. Do you sip water? You need to sip of water. Sip your water. Guys, if you need a little extra time, take it. Again, Lori and I are probably a little extended today with our breaks. So we're looking at about 45 to 60 seconds. Depending on the weight and the volume and what kind of rep count you're doing, is going to, like I mentioned earlier, it's going to dictate how long you're going to be working. So, I'm going to get another wipe and then we're going to jump back in. And there goes the ball. Let a ball roll. Lori will chase it. Let's go. You know, that's a good way for, you know what they say, people in offices, get a stability ball.
I think it might work on one.
Yeah, that's a good way to be a little more fit. All right, stabilization during work. There's been research on that. Get a stability ball instead of a chair. You can do a lot with the stability ball, believe it or not. A little more than you can do with a beanbag, even though a beanbag may be a little bit more comfy. All right, good. Don't forget your press there, show off. You want to be a go-getter, you got to stick with it. Let's go. Good. In that zone, Lori. How you feeling?
Good.
Oh, we are almost home. I mean, Andy's going to be jealous. She got her workout in. Maybe. Maybe not. Go four more, which would be eight. Three more, let's go. Two more. Last one, fly out. Nicely done. All right, we're gonna go into our high rows, the high band rows here. So right in. Look at my elbows. All right, see how my hands are? Keep your posture, chest is forward towards the door. High pull.
And a yawn does not mean your
forehead. Face pulls.
It means you're
trying to get some oxygen up to that big old noggin. Let's roll. Come on, little
bit. Working.
Switch your hands, or switch knee band. So rotate it over. So it's, there you go. All right, guys, let's go. It's still working, coming up on the hour. Look, elbows, she wants to bring those elbows down because it's easier for her. Squeeze, good. Right on time here, Jolly Lean. 54 minutes into the routine. Keep it up, sink in a little bit. We're not doing legs today, but I assure you, they're coming up in our next workout. So we've got these kettlebells, if you got them at home, join us for our next workout, all right? And a little bit of shoulders and cores and that whole, we like to work A lot. I'm gonna say a little bit of a lot, but we do it all here. I'm gonna say three sounds like a good number. Get those elbows back. Do I have to put my nose there again? Come on.
Yes.
Let's see it. Go, go, go. Oh, all right. Last one. Relax. Nice job. All right, right in the X press here. Keep it up. Yeah, that works. There you go. Again, if that's too easy, yeah, thank you. She does not. See, sometimes people want to go easy on themselves. She's not one of them. All right? She always goes hard on herself. Maybe hard on herself. Not good all the time, but in a workout, she goes hard. Go big or go home. Let's go. Can you just do a hop?
No.
A little heel up?
No.
Like a little yippy skippy? Come on. Keep it up. Think happy thoughts. Never know what's going on up there sometimes. We're going to say five more. Let's go. Come on. Totally. Three strong. And relax. Flip it and whip it here, Lean. Come on. A little gas there. Breathe. Take a step back. We're almost home. Finish stronger than you started. You know that old saying. Come on. Bring it in your feet. Just a bit. Maybe a little more difficult. Five more. Last three. Two. One. Give me one more. Relax. Two in the books, one to go. Jolene, how you feeling? She's ready for a nap. She does like the stability ball. You kick your feet up here. I don't know, we'll have to put you in a crib because that'll roll one way or the other and that won't be good. Guys at home, if you're still with us, thanks for sticking with us and way to work, all right? But there's still one round to go. So guys, if you're satisfied with the workout, fantastic. You've got something in. If you're still with us, time to find that stability ball and finish stronger than you started. Lee, you ready to roll?
Yes.
All right, let's see. This one's backwards, so let's go. All right, let's go.
What are you doing again?
Get the rest of the day, the flies. That one. With the neutral grip press. You like red on the outside. Come on. This is it, Lori. Right? Find that zone, find your space, get it done. Perfect form. Form is good. Guys, if you've seen the camera, notice the bridge here. Notice her hips are extended. All right. You could have lunch on that table right there. That's how flat your stomach looks, great. Flat. It's like a washboard there. That is what you're striving for. All right, glutes are tight, they are activated, the core is activated, pectoralis or chest is activated, biceps, see the tension there, right there, bring it together, and then the press in, the chest press right there, anterior delts, triceps. Let's go. Go three, lean. Shot. And one more. Nice job, Lori. Say goodbye to the dumbbells. Power block. All right, you got your face pulls, band face pulls. I almost lost the train of thought. I forgot what they're called. This is a face pull with the yellow band. Again, this is a light band. All right, the farther you step back with it, the more work you're going to get or the more resistance you're going to get from there with the tension. Good. Squeeze, traps. Steps rotate through. Alright, and again, you can go into an isometric. You can't really see, or maybe you can, but you can go into a squat and isometric position or static position for your the legs and your muscle, or don't legs, your muscles in the leg. So she could stand upright, but this also gives her a better base. So if she came up, it would be hard, it'll be a little more difficult for her to stay in this position. So she's got her imaginary chair here, and she's indirectly working her lower extremity. Go to, Laura. Finish strong. And relax, step in. And ladies and gentlemen, one last move, Laura. This is it. You got axe press. We're going to start this way, as we've started the last two times. And this is it. Guys, anything can be accomplished. Make it start right at home, all right? We've come this far, we're an hour in. She is still smiling, which I don't think it means I went too easy. That's just her face. It's like, it's permanent. She's got a poignant tattoo. And it's a good one, because it's a beautiful smile. She does everything with a smile. Keep that foot, give a look and smile. Show them how you smile. See that? That's not fake. That's been there since we started. Let's go. Keep that at home as well. Let's roll. She's almost laughing now. Go three more. And switch other side. Let's go, guys. Right here. She's made it thus far. There's that guess. She probably has a bagel waiting for her at home. Let's go.
Magic Fountain opens at noon.
Magic Fountain opens at noon. I think we're past that. Guys, I would not have a sundae after a workout like this. Complex carbohydrates, protein, good combination of both. Alright. I don't know, jungle juice is a good combo, but
oh,
guys,
there you go.
Yeah, jungle juice. Lori likes jungle juice. Alright, but make something at home. Whole foods are good, obviously, and also everything's to go anyway. So be smart about traveling out and be vigilant about everyone else. But whole foods at home is the best way to go for recovery. Good combination of carbohydrates and protein afterward. Chocolate milk is said to be a good recovery. Lori likes to blow bubbles in her chocolate milk still. Is that it? Maybe three more. You got me talking. Might as well put the icing on the cake. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a wrap. Nice job, airless hug. Guys, it is Thursday afternoon. My phone is not working right. I couldn't tell you, but assuming it's 12:45. Guys, you got the rest of the day ahead of you. When this is filmed, all right, there's no reason. This isn't a live stream yet, but hopefully we're gonna work to that at some point. Get up, get at them. If you're rolling around watching Netflix, nothing wrong with that. Maybe watch Chatham Club flicks right now when you get out. Get to work. Guys, think positive, stay positive, inspire others, motivate others. If you need a little push, guys, we are all here for you. People like Lori are here for you. I don't know what she's doing right now, but that works. I want to thank Lori for being my first video at home. Guys, talk to your trainers, talk to your friends, get together with people. Again, watch your spacing and gathering, be smart about that. But find a way to get through this. Stay strong.